r/askreddit by Reddit and chill. What are you 99% sure of? That all lyric websites just steal from whichever website uploads the lyrics first. Several websites will share the exact same lyrics with one another. Not uncommon if they're correct lyrics, but they'll have a word misspelled or misplaced. Or the lyrics will just be off entirely. I wonder if misspellings are like paper streets like the map makers do to see if they've been copied. That my mom will never use the china plates she put away until a special occasion happens. My mom has a set of nice china plateaua, including a nice china teapot. About 10 years ago I printed out a little cutout of Waldo, signed and dated the back, and hid it in the teapot. She still hasn't found it. The steak place near my house that never has customers and always is open is money laundering. Went to an Italian place once like this. We walked in to try something new and the person who came out of the back was genuinely surprised. He seemed to be going through the motions of getting us our menus and to our seats with one eye on us as if we were up to something he didn't trust. A few people came out of the kitchen while we were there and were chatting us up about how we came to be there and if we were enjoying our meal. We were the only diners in the whole place. Years later my husband and I are driving by and he points to the place and says, "You know, I used to service the pool table in there and I'm 99% sure they're a front for something." So I give him a wide-eyed expression and tell him about eating there like 7 years prior and how I felt the exact same way. We're both now 100% convinced it's a front for something. Good pasta though. My birthday. My parents claim that my birth certificate was off by one day. So they had it fixed. Apparently someone at the hospital just made a mistake. Still. Can't help but wonder if it was right before and I'm actually one day older than I think I am. 99% sure I know my birthday. I know of someone who said her parents knew she was born a certain day, but the birth certificate said a different day. And one person that was present at the birth said it was neither of those and was a different day. She celebrates a birth week. I turned the oven off. Did you know? Okay. So I somehow keep losing bobby pins. I'm not the kind of person to just toss them everywhere. I put them in this one red bowl. The bowl just keeps getting more and more empty. My roommate has a buzz cut. So she's out. I think the cat is stealing my bobby pins and hoarding them somewhere. I don't know why. She's not doing it when I'm at home. The vet hasn't even found anything in her stomach. She also likes pulling tacks out of the wall and magnets off of the fridge, nor does she seem to have discomfort. I think my cat has a nest of shinies somewhere. I will find it. I'm 99% sure you need a camera on that red bowl. And 100% sure you should come back and tell us that other humans actually exist and are not figments of my imagination. I heard an interesting theory that we each are experiencing our own universes and everyone reading this is in my universe. But the me you're reading is the me of your universe. And to go even further, each of us will never experience our own death unless it's absolutely avoidable. Thus we all will, in our own universes, will likely die of old age. Whether or not it's true is largely irrelevant. I'm 99% sure that the 1% doubt I have is grossly misjudged and should be a bigger percentage. That's paradoxical. My pants are zipped. I've had a weird number of unzipped fly moments in the last month or so. Like, in the last 10 years it's maybe happened 2 times. But it's happened 3 times this month. Starting to worry that I'm either slowly losing my mental faculties, or that I'm noticing it more. And have been vastly underestimating the number of times it's happened previously. That there's life on another planet. Maybe we'll never find it. Maybe it's the size of a bacteria, but there has to be another planet with life. This one actually ducks me up thinking about it. I should be 100% sure. But the fact that there's absolutely zero evidence or signs is unsettling. That is not the real Benjamin Franklin. I don't care what Jim says. That I can't trust this fart. I need an update on this. That I won't make it to the end of these comments before I decide to bail and keep perusing random articles. That as much as I love Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, sadly, the answer to the question of life, the universe, and everything is not 42. Actually, it is correct. 42 is the SCI code for asterisk. Anyone that knows computer code knows that an asterisk is typically used for wildcard. Or, in simpler terms, it refers to anything, any letter, number, word or symbol. So what I think Douglas Adams, author of Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, was trying to say is that life can mean anything to anyone. I exist. Do you? I won't die at exactly this second. Update. That 99% of all statistics are made up. You've become the very thing you swore to destroy. That I locked my door before I left my house. The 1% makes me go back to see if I'm right. My cat, as he looks at me intently with his deep green intelligent looking eyes, understands the gist of what I'm saying to him. Of course he does. Just like when he locks his eyes on you and yells meow. You kinda know what he wants to. That one day, life on Earth will end suddenly and abruptly. And there will be abso-ducking-lutely nothing we can do about it. Life on Earth will cease to exist. And all the grand and amazing things we have done here will be forgotten. Things as big as world wars will be forgotten like a sand grain thrown into a desert. Help me. Like Tez in the rain. The suffix ito in Spanish means little. So. Therefore. Dorito means little Doro. Implying the existence of a legendary and giant snack called Doro. I asked my mom, who is a native Spanish speaker, and she said Doro just means toasted. Sorry guys. I'm idiot. You're not idiot. You're an idiot. That American financier and convicted sex offender Jeffrey Edward Epstein didn't commit suicide at the Metropolitan Correctional Center based in New York City. I read a theory that I'm 99% sure of. He's not even dead. His money and girlfriend both disappeared before he died. Epstein is living on one of his pedo islands as happy as can be. Edit. Marks. My sexuality. Gay. The rapture is not going to occur today. Yeah. Todd. That Filipino people. That work at call centers in the Philippines. Are giving an American name to use each day because the lady. Who had an accent thicker than that bowl of adobo she ate yesterday. Was not a goddamn Cheryl. Edit. Lots of feedback with a high chance they do have American names from all the comments. But I still hold my suspicions. I work in Canada in a call center. With a good number of Indian people. About 50% of them use a more North American name based loosely of their real name. Arpan equals Archie. Chirag equals CJ. Varshith equals Val. Bharath equals Brett. So yeah. It's normal for this to happen. I'm 99.99% sure that 99.99% germs get eliminated after using hand sanitizer. Her cheeks tastes way better than mine. I'm going to need context for this one. China lies about the coronavirus. Yeah. You don't go from arresting the guy who wanted to warn people to sharing accurate statistics worldwide. The Spanish flu got that name because although most of Europe was sick and dying, only Spain reported accurate numbers. Bigfoot does not exist. Bigfoot does exist. My mate showed me pictures of Monster Jam and Bigfoot was there with other monster trucks. That if I get a date GF I will somehow duck it up. Dating and relationships aren't about the other person. They're about how you relate to the other person. You can't ever have a good relationship until you have a good relationship with yourself. I know. I sound like a stupid self-help guru, but it's true. You need to be comfortable with yourself before you can have a good relationship with someone else. It took me decades to learn that. Be selfish for a moment. What do you want? Be realistic. If it's not right, then bounce. Work on yourself. Remember, you don't pay your counselor to help you or listen to you be a little bitch. You pay your counselor for honesty. You pay them for the privilege of that outside looking in perspective. You pay them to tell you the things your friends won't. The important things. Getting a counselor or psychologist is not embarrassing. It's brave. Be one of the few who can admit to themselves that I need another perspective. Hey. I know. Let's pay a pro for an honest opinion. And how about not getting bent out of shape when it arrives? that I'm essentially wasting my time at a job to make money that will be utterly worthless when WW3 happens. Bottom line. Whoever's idea was it to trade goods and services for fucking paper? Thanks a lot, buddy Al. I'm 99% sure Cry is going bend me over again. Canada Revenue Agency. Acker the Tax Man. Edit. Clarification. That I'll never get married. From how awful my parents' divorce was when I was a kid. To the awful men my mom dated. And my own bad luck with having two of the loves of my life break up W me out of the blue. I'm pretty sure I will never marry. I feel like there's no point. And no positive aspects to it. There is no afterlife. Our minds still function for a certain amount of time after death. We slip in and out of dreams as the last few synapses send electric signals across our brain. At some point our brains decompose to the point they can't function at all. Anyone who tells a story about how they were dead and experienced a form of the afterlife didn't really do so. Their brain remained intact, hence the fact they are still capable of being conscious. Sleep tight. That about 99% of problems in the world are caused by people's attitudes to the issue. More than the issues themselves. We don't have free will. Ducking like and subscribe.